So reduction to order is another really, really awesome method for solving second order ODEs. And these are good for, or this would be good if you have like a non-constant coefficient thingy. Basically, the idea is if you can figure out one of the solutions, because if it's a second order ODE, it's going to have two solutions. But if you can figure out one of the solutions, then you can guess that the full solution is going to be some function of that. And then you can use this kind of a cool trick to solve the resulting problem. So let me write this up for you. So say you've got something like this. It says, find the general solution of blah, 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 given that blah, blah, blah is one of the solutions. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to guess a solution that a full solution is going to look something like some unknown function times the known function. And now we're just going to do a quick little derivative thingy, u prime e to the x plus u, the prime of the second, which is just the second thing. And then we're going to double this up. This. So there we go. And we're going to plug it in. So we're going to plug this guy in. Oh, that's not a plus sign. Oops. That's not a plus sign. That's an equal sign. All right. So we're going to do this thingy. And it's going to go here. And this thingy is going to go here. And this thingy is going to go here. Beautiful. All right. So I'm actually going to start by pulling an e to the x out front. Alright, and when I do that, I'll have x times yellow stuff. That's not a yellow. X times yellow stuff, which is going to be u double prime plus 2u prime plus u. And then minus 2x plus 1 times green stuff, which is u prime plus u. And then plus x plus 1 times blue stuff, which is just going to be u, and that's equal to 0. And I can go through here, and I can multiply the whole thing times e to the minus x, because that's never going to be 0, which basically just makes that go away. And now I'm going to distribute. So I've got u double prime times x. U prime is going to be times, let's see, 2x minus 2x minus 1 plus x plus 1. No, just those. 2x minus 1. And then the u by itself is going to be multiplied by x minus 2x minus 1 and plus x plus 1. That was a funny sound. And then I'm going to go through x u double prime plus, no, minus u prime and then 0. Beautiful. Okay, and you say, well, I still can't solve this stupid thing because it's a second order thingy. And I'm like, but wait, we can fix that. I'm actually just going to pretend that it's not. I'm going to let z equal to u prime, and therefore z prime is equal to u double prime, and I'm going to make a straightforward substitution. So u double prime is z prime minus u prime, which is z, is 0, and check it out. Now I have a first order homogeneous ordinary differential equation, and I can solve this. And I'm going to pretend nothing else has happened, and all I have to do in the entire world is solve this. So if this is equal to, well, I'll do this. Do-do-do-do-do, like that. 1 over z, z prime is equal to 1 over x. So I've got 1 over z, dz, 1 over x. I guess I could have done this like a host of other ways, but I'm just doing it this way because it makes me feel better. Integrate. Natural log of z, natural log of x plus c, e to the natural log of x plus c is equal to z. So z is equal to some unknown constant times x. Beautiful. Lovely. Exciting. Good. All right. Now I knew that z was equal to u prime. So cx is equal to u prime. So du, well, I'm going to turn around the other way. U prime is equal to cx. There, that just looks better. Du is equal to cx dx. Integrate. And that means that u is equal to 1 half cx squared plus c2, some other c2. We'll make that c1 now. Except that who cares if it's 1 half times a constant? We'll just make it another constant. Now, if you'll remember, in our original problem, we had a guess And we guessed that y, our full solution, was equal to u times e to the x. And that's way up here, if you care to remember. So that was way up there. So now all we have to do is apply the new u that we found. C1x squared C2 times e to the x. And that would be our full solution that we could then apply with any initial conditions that we happen to have. So really the trick to this is just reducing it to something that's going to look like this, and then using that substitution. And this is going to hopefully happen every time as long as you use the proper initial guess. So let's do one more. All right, so we've got this one. We have this blah, blah, blah equation given that y1 equals x is the solution. So my recommendation, pause the video, see how far you can get, and then come back and see if you got it right. So let's pretend that happened. So we have a solution. That means that we're gonna guess a full solution of y is equal to u times x. So y prime, u prime x plus u, y double prime, u prime double prime x plus u prime plus u prime. There we go. Beautiful. Next, we're going to plug stuff in. Oops, not that. We're going to plug stuff in. Do-do-do-do-do is this guy. And do-do-do-do-do is this guy. And do-do-do-do-do is this guy. Yay! All right, so I have x squared times green stuff. No, why aren't you playing along? That's just going to look stupid. X squared times green stuff. And that's going to be u double prime x plus 2u prime minus 3x times blue stuff, which is u prime x plus u, and then plus 3 times yellow stuff, which is ux, and that has to equal 0. So let's see what we can do. All right, so my u double prime is going to have coefficients of x cubed, and that's it. My u prime is going to have a 2x squared, a minus 3x squared, and I think that's it. And then my u by itself is going to have a minus 3x plus 3x. Ooh, that's good. I was kind of hoping for that. So I've got x cubed, u double prime, minus x squared. Come here, girl. What are you doing? Minus x squared u prime is equal to 0. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to factor out an x squared, and it's going to give me x u double prime minus u prime is equal to 0. Good. Now, so that means that either x is going to be equal to 0, which is just fine, it's just a useless solution. So either that's the solution and the only solution, or I have that this here is equal to 0. And luckily for us, although this wasn't entirely intentional, this is the exact same thing that we had on the previous problem. So if you didn't notice and you just solved it, great. If you did notice, go ahead and work through it again just to make sure. But we showed already that the solution to that is going to be that y is equal to some constant x squared plus some other constant. So the full solution is going to be that y is equal to, we said ux, so u c1 x squared plus c2 times x, or simply c1x cubed plus c2x. And so you can see that if x is 0, then y equals 0 would be a solution, which makes sense, because if I scroll up here and look at the original problem, if I say that y is equal to 0, then y double prime is clearly 0, and y prime and y double prime are both 0, and that would just be that 0 equals 0. So that is a trivial solution, and I can keep that if I want to, but it's not really that helpful. But this does encompass that as well, and that gives us the full solution that we could then apply initial conditions to.